What's going on, YouTube? I'm back with another video. I'm here with one of my buddies from work, Connor.
That's me, I'm Connor.
Today, we're going to be dipping on some Copenhagen Southern Blend. So, we're going to give this baby a little crack.
Good crack.
Oh, that's a beautiful sound right there.
Look, one try.
And then, give it a nice little sniff.
Let me get a whiff off of that. Let me get a nice one.
Oh, it smells so good, man.
That's that Copenhagen flavor.
That's Copenhagen.
That's the one they like.
Now, you're going to pack and look at the cut.
Woo!
Got that nice Copenhagen cut on it that you love. And, of course, you got that missing pinch for Chris Kyle. Got to have
that's
a pinch.
That's his
fork. That's, yep. You got to have that pinch for Chris. So, get a little. Got that pinch up going on. Yeah, get a little killer filler going on in there.
Yeah, this will be interesting too, because I actually haven't had this in over a year. One of my good buddies, Tony Ray, he used to dip this shit every single day.
Yeah, so. Man. Dude, I love this shit, man. It's one of my favorite dips.
It's got a good smell. It kind of smells like leather for some weird reason.
It's southern, dude. You have that it has that molasses taste to it,
and the cut's a little bit finer.
It's more the Copenhagen long cut other than like the winter.
I would call this snuff for people that don't like snuff.
Mm-hmm.
And same thing with the taste. It tastes almost exactly like Copenhagen long cut, except it's a little bit less dry.
Yeah, and you got that sort of molasses taste to it. It tastes like something you would find in the sup. Like, you got the molasses to it.
This just took me back to Georgia. 1922. Yep, that's that's the flavor you want to savor.
Yeah, man.
That's a good one.
It's a good flavor, man. But
yeah, I think you can pick up a little bit of... it's got some whiskey vibes to it. A little bit of charcoal, maybe.
Once it sets a while, you can start tasting a little bit of that sweetness from the molasses.
Yeah, it makes your mouth juice up real quick.
It does, man. Today, I'm going to be spitting in that Stealth Mud jug that I got a couple weeks ago. Yeah, I already did a review on it.
Y'all should go check it out. I'm using the Olive Draft Green Mud Jug of Champions.
Yep.
Can't go wrong with a classic.
You can't.
Can't go wrong with a classic.
I need my mom to send me the rest of my classics up here.
Get that collection going.
I need to, man. I got like 10 mud jugs back in Florida at my mom's house.
You're spitting for days.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, this Southern Blend says satisfaction since 1822. I feel it.
Yeah.
This is a relatively old can, too, because it expires at the end of December.
Really?
It's still actually pretty good.
Oh, shit. No, it's a sell-by date.
Sell by.
That's a sell by date, December 31st, New Year's Eve. Got it just in time.
What is the, how long is the sell date after the manufacture date? Do you know that? Maybe 6 months or so? Maybe
30? I actually don't know that. I think usually, I guess it mainly depends on the brand, the cut, and the flavor of it. Because some flavors last longer than others, and
that
some brands
sense.
Are different. Like Stoker's is a more of a juicier than Copenhagen or Grizzly.
July 5th of next year.
Yeah.
So
Stoker's is more juicier and a little bit longer cut than Copenhagen. So since it's juicier, it takes longer for the juices to.
Stoker's, you'll find a whole tree branch in there sometimes. If you get the tub, there's a whole fucking stick in there.
Yeah, man.
So.
That's one thing I don't like about Stoker's, because I don't like. Dipping on trees.
Yeah, it's not.
But it has a good flavor to it. But with Copenhagen, it's all, like, you never have any stems with Copenhagen. Copenhagen does a really fine job of getting the stems out of their dips. So.
And therefore you have the price, which is twice as much as Stoker's. So
exactly.
It's better refined.
It's a better cut. The flavors don't last as long because they're not as, well, the Southern Blend is not nearly as juicy as Copenhagen Wintergreen, so the flavor doesn't last as long. but at the same time.
Yeah, I would say
it's a finer cut than the wintergreen.
I would say if you ever tried Copenhagen and didn't like it, like just long cut, you just took Copenhagen long cut and did not like it for any type of reason, it could be the cut's too fine or the flavor's too intense. This right here might be what you need to try out before you go back to hitting the big boy stuff like the long cut or the snuff. Now, snuff for me, I don't like at all. I don't like snuff. I can't ever keep it packed, and then it always creeps down your throat. Yeah. I have a pretty strong gag reflex, which might be a good thing if I'm ever in a gay bar. But for the most part, it's really smooth. It's not intense.
Yeah.
It's a good if you're really hooked on wintergreen or mint or any sort of other fruity ass flavor like berry blend. If you're just a little girl and love berry blend, and you're wanting to try something to put some hair on your balls, I would say Southern Blend is the one to do it without overdoing it.
Yeah.
It's pretty good. It's a mild flavor. Good buzz, manageable buzz. It's not like a big old juicy dip of grizzly, but it'll I have a feeling that this you could keep this in for 5 or 6 hours just fine. Flip it a couple times.
Yeah.
I know from experience just Copenhagen Wintergreen. It dries out really quick.
It does.
Compared to grizzly, but I guarantee you this right here to me tastes better than any other natural flavor. And it's not as intense as Copenhagen Black either. Copenhagen Black's really
it has that strong bourbon flavor into it.
Yeah,
I love bourbon. I'm a fan of bourbon. I drink bourbon all the time. But for some reason, Copenhagen Black gives me heartburn.
Yeah, I can see that.
I don't know why. I ain't drink bourbon just fine. I ain't drink bourbon from sun up to sun down, and I'll be just fine. But whenever it comes
to be drunk.
Yeah. Oh, no doubt about it, man. Yep. That's the main point of drinking bourbon. You want to get drunk. But I don't know if it's what they put into it. It just gives me heartburn. That's why Copenhagen Black, I'm glad it's a seasonal. I like the flavor of it. It has a good flavor. But if I dip that every single day, my heart might be on fire and I'll die.
Now, here's something that I don't understand, and probably a lot of other people don't understand, is about 4 years ago, they switched Copenhagen Extra Long Cut, turned it into Copenhagen Black. And a lot of people say, oh, it's the same thing. But it's not. For some undistinguishable reason, or this is Extra Long
That's
Cut?
That's Extra Long Cut Natural.
Okay. So they must have, because they did have one that was Copenhagen Black Extra Long Cut for a while.
Yeah, they did. Whenever they first, I think it was their second year out. Whenever they started doing the seasonal, they did. I think they did have it as an extra long cut, mm-hmm. which I did not care. I like the original because it has, which is pretty much the same one that I did a review on a couple weeks ago. It was more the original flavor of the black. It still had some differences with the taste. But then I think it was the second or third year, they tried it with an extra long cut, which I did not like. I think it had too much flavor. It was just too much of a strong bourbon taste to it. But then they switched it again where they had the black cans with it, the black and gold, which was okay, but it still had a too strong flavor. The cut was a little bit too
long. Had branches in it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was too long of a cut, and then they came out with the Copenhagen Black Weyman's Reserve, which sort of put it back to the original.
Yeah, that's one I haven't tried yet. But,
yeah, it's really good, man.
Yeah, because I've noticed that extra long cut, it wasn't the same flavor as regular Coke. Mm-hmm. And see, that's the one thing, too, which is really kind of strange to me about Copenhagen.
Like all their
everything tastes different.
Yes, their snuff has a different flavor than the long cut, and then the three natural flavors for Copenhagen is their snuff, their long cut, and their extra long cut natural. They all have a different flavor. I think it's mainly because the cut.
Yeah, that might be.
The finer the cut gets, the less
drier it is.
Yeah, the drier it is, and the more flavor it loses. I mainly, as I told y'all a couple videos ago, I'm going to do a full can challenge here in a few weeks or so. I picked up the extra long cut natural just because you want that extra, you want a longer cut because it's easier to pack, it's easier to pinch. So a longer cut is easier.
And it's easier to spit out too.
It is.
I mean, it's easy. You don't gotta.
You don't have.
You can spit it out. You don't gotta dig your finger in.
Yeah.
Like snuff, you gotta get a toothpick out to go to town. Yeah, that's the one thing I've noticed is a lot of people that dip snuff anyways.
They always have fucking dip in their mouth.
Yeah, or it's like they never spit it out. They just keep putting more in. So you'll go, like, the type of people that dip three cans a day, chances are you're dipping snow, or
yeah.
You're just junkies. But yeah, this is decent. I mean, I haven't dipped, other than just earlier this evening, I haven't dipped in probably 4 or 5 days, and I'm really sensitive to nicotine. Even if, like, if I were to go out right now and smoke a cigarette, I'd be fucking jumping off the wall, feeling like I'm about to fall down. But right now, it's there. It's just not too much. A lot of people that are experienced dippers don't even get buzzes anymore.
No, I don't get.
I still do every single time. I'm like a little kid. But, you know, you never want to be dissatisfied by what you dip. And I don't think that this would do that. I would highly recommend this to anybody. I mean, I have a buddy that, old Tony Rayangelo. He used to dip this shit every fucking day, and he's the only person I've ever seen that has this besides Mr. Southern here. And so maybe it's just a matter of refined taste, but
yeah,
it's pretty good shit. I would recommend it to anybody.
I'm a huge fan.
Doesn't know what they're doing.
Copenhagen Southern Blend is probably my favorite Copenhagen, mainly because not only because it has my name in it,
it's got your name on the can.
I know, dude.
Can't go wrong.
But I'm from a small town in Florida, country town. We use molasses all the time. We like smoking anything. We smoke briskets, ribs, turkeys, hams, deer shoulders.
Reefer.
Yep.
We
smoke everything. We fry everything. So this mainly, whenever I do it, I taste the smokiness in the dip. I taste the molasses. It pretty much takes me back home. That's one.
And it kind of tastes like summer, honestly.
It does.
It tastes like summer, which is a weird thing to say, but it does have some sort of, it's got a certain element to it that you can't really describe. It almost kind of like a, it's got the same flavor as like the whiskey blend does, just a little bit, which I'm not even sure if they still make whiskey blend.
I know
it's really rare.
It's the Cope brand of Copenhagen, which Cope had the Cope whiskey, the Cope straight, and the Cope. I can't remember.
Yeah, the red can, the straight. Yeah, I used
it was
to,
the
man,
it was,
is it still around anymore?
I have not seen that in years.
Yeah,
I know. I mean, I tried them all when they first came out because I wanted to try it. The whiskey was sort of like the black, except instead of the bourbon, you had the whiskey flavor. It wasn't a strong whiskey flavor, which...
It tasted like whenever you get whiskey, and the first thing, whenever you crack open the bottle, it doesn't taste like whiskey. It tastes like what the smell of whiskey is.
Yeah.
It's got like that kind of burnt wood flavor to it, like slightly charcoal, but kind of like maple.
Yeah.
This one has that maple smoky taste.
That's
minus the whiskey. The whiskey. It doesn't have that
that maple
that
taste
darker,
from the molasses.
Whatever that darker is, it doesn't. So I think this one's probably, it's like a lighter blend. If this were a beer, just like I'm looking at this bottle right here, this Guinness Blonde.
Yeah.
If regular Cope is Guinness, this would be Guinness Blonde. It's kind of like Cope Light, I guess. But it's not like straight, or it's not cheap. Shitty.
It's like the perfect balance. It's not too sweet like the straight is, but it's not too natural like the natural dips are. It's that perfect balance in between. You get the sweetness like you would from a straight cut, but then you also get that nicotine, the natural flavors, which I think is where the smokiness comes in from the actual tobacco. But for y'all that don't know, Copenhagen used to have two seasonal dips. Southern Blend was the other seasonal dip. You used to only be able to get Southern Blend during the spring times, like spring and summer, and then come fall, they would take Southern Blend off the shelves, and then they would replace that with the black.
Mm-hmm.
So that's also a thing where Southern Blend was from, I think they started putting that back on the shelves around March, taking it off whenever, around October when black would come out. And then black would be out from October until about end of February when they'll start putting Southern Blend.
Yeah, because when I used to work at Quick Trip, it was kind of weird though, because like if we still had Southern Blend in the fall, it always had like the 50¢ off sticker on it.
Yeah,
they're just trying to get rid of the stuff from earlier that year.
Yeah,
but yeah, I mean you can. I think Copenhagen, if you're looking for a high quality dip, like every time, if you have the consistency, Copenhagen's always consistent.
Yeah.
You're never going to get a can and open and be like, oh, well, that's weird. That's different than the last can I bought. Sometimes Grizzly's like that. I know Red Seal is like that
Red
a lot.
Red Seal is like that. Stoker's is like that a lot. Like, the two most popular brands are Copenhagen and Grizzly. Copenhagen has a slight edge because it's been around longer. It's more of a refined
kind
cut.
Kind of traditional.
Yeah. Copenhagen was the first dip to come out. Weyman came out with Copenhagen 1822. The first one he came out with was the Copenhagen Snuff in 1822. And then I think it was around 1824 he came out with the Long Cut. And from there, it just started booming. So he had started making the pouches, the wintergreens. The mint came out a few years. I think mint came out about 4 years ago all around for every company. And then they did the Southern Blend, the black, and then whatever is on, everything start, all dips started in 1822 with Copenhagen. Copenhagen is the grandfather of dip.
I think he was originally from Denmark or something, wasn't he? Like a Danish guy? It's pretty interesting. Like,
I think so.
Over in Europe, like back in the day, I mean, snuff was a big deal. Like,
yeah.
Forever. Used to be, you know, Swedish people, a lot of Germans would put it right in their nose with a little spoon.
Mm-hmm.
And then that was snuff originally, because that's what snuff
it's
means.
Called
it means
nasal
to sniff.
Snuff.
It means
yeah.
to sniff in German, I'm pretty sure, or Danish, or
some European country.
Whatever that language might be. It's Germanic, I guess. But, a lot of people used to do that. Actually, my aunt has a little old container. She's really big into antique shit. And she has an old snuff container, and it's like this little porcelain pot, but it has a little tiny spoon in it.
Yep.
And some people are like, oh, do you put cocaine in there? Well, I mean, you could.
You could. It's mainly for tobacco.
But, yeah, and then one thing I really think is they don't make this in pouches.
No.
That's what's kind of fucked up, because the people that – I know a lot of people. I mean, I used to only dip pouches just because it was kind of more convenient. And you'd keep your teeth a little bit cleaner.
Especially if you're like in a professional workplace.
Yeah, exactly.
You don't have to spit
you're
as much.
You're kind of limited to what... With pouches, you're limited to wintergreen and just
natural.
Regular Copenhagen.
Yeah.
There's no mint even.
Nope.
There's no any of these special flavors.
No.
I think that's kind of... It kind of sucks because like all these people that like pouches, I know a lot of people that will only dip pouches. And they're missing out on some good flavors.
They're limited to either Copenhagen natural, Copenhagen wintergreen, fucking Grizzly Wintergreen, Grizzly Natural. I think Grizzly Mint has a pouch. Grizzly has a pouch for mint.
Mm-hmm.
So that's,
I don't like Grizzly Mint, though. I don't like it that much. Because it's a different, like the mint for Grizzly is a different type of mint. Like, okay. Because there's spearmint and peppermint.
Mm-hmm.
Peppermint's kind of a little bit more spicy, just like the name pepper. But, Grizzly kind of leans more towards a peppermint side.
Mm-hmm.
And the wintergreen Copenhagen kind of shares a similar flavor with the Grizzly Mint.
Yeah.
I think, anyways. But, when it comes to mint, though, I think Copenhagen Mint. No, they do make mint pouches in Copenhagen, actually.
They did. I have not seen
My roommate actually dips those quite a bit, and he doesn't even dip. So, I mean, that says that, you know. He smokes cigarettes like a fucking chimney.
Yeah.
But he will not throw in a dip unless it's a pouch. And if it's mint, and that's just like, you know, shit, broaden your horizons a little bit.
I know, man.
Yeah, it's Southern Blend is really, it's just a good, I think it's a good baseline to base other things off of, because it's so,
it's mild tasting. It's not too sweet. It's not too natural. It doesn't have that many tastes. It has a nice smoky flavor with a hint of molasses to it.
Yeah, and I would say if you really like the flavor of just regular Copenhagen long cut, and you don't want to pay $6 a can, Copenhagen Southern Blend is where you want to be. Mm-hmm. That's the good. It's got pretty much everything you're looking for. Well, like whenever you think Copenhagen, the flavor of Copenhagen, that's what you get. It's the same flavor as long cut, except it's in a plastic can and it's a little bit more mild and it's not as dry.
Yeah.
But it's also not as moist as, let's say, you know, black or extra long cut or the whiskey blend for sure. The whiskey blend is very wet, or just from what I remember. I haven't had it in a couple of years, but it's sometimes you'll open up a can, it's pretty crazy, but it's still pretty consistent.
Yeah. Dude, I wish that I have not seen Cope brand anywhere in like 3 years. If y'all live around somewhere with some Cope, not Copenhagen, but actually the Cope brand of Copenhagen, it had the three flavors, the whiskey, the straight, I think smooth hickory was the final flavor, which smooth hickory, it did not have much flavor to it at all.
I never even heard of that.
I tried it once. Like, I tried it once when it first came out. I didn't much care for it, but then I got into collecting the cans and everything, and I had thrown the can out, and I was just looking for the can. I was just wanting to get some just for the can of it, and I could not find it anywhere. Like, whenever I start collecting cans, I was not able to find any of the Cope brands. If y'all live somewhere with some Cope, y'all should send me some. I want to try it again. I haven't had that in like 3-4 years, and I think it would be a nice experiment just to try again. See.
Yeah, there's probably a few regional flavors we haven't heard of yet.
Oh, no.
I'm sure there is.
Like some brands that I really like that I cannot find here. Hawkins is a really good brand. They make some good flavor. They have good flavors. Tough Guy, I can't find around here. If you want to do a full can challenge, Tough Guy is the best to do it because they got that fat cut, which is longer than an extra long cut, and it's also wider. So it makes it's easier to pinch, pack, everything. Tough Guy is actually the brand you want to use to do a full can. But since I can't find that anywhere, I don't know anywhere that has it where I live, I just went ahead and picked up some Copenhagen extra long cut natural. Cause whenever I do full cans, I like doing the natural flavor because you don't have that strong minty taste or any other taste. You just get that pure natural taste, which is also a good thing for full can challenge.
Yeah, you don't want to get too overwhelmed with if you do a full can of Wintergreen, for some reason I feel like I would just almost start sneezing. You know what I mean? That much mint, that'd be crazy.
My first full can challenge was a full can of Grizzly Long Cut Wintergreen, and it just burned the hell out of my gums because that minty taste to it, the Wintergreen taste to it, just killed my gums. Which, after I did that challenge, I quit dipping Wintergreen. No matter what the Wintergreen brand was, I quit dipping Wintergreen for like 3 months. And then I just wanted that taste again, so I went out and bought a can.
I'm actually going to look up, really quick, the other types, all of the varieties of Copenhagen that are made.
I know they got the long cut, extra long cut natural, southern blend, black right now, Wintergreen, mint, Copenhagen pouches, Copenhagen Wintergreen pouches. I guess now they got the Copenhagen black pouches. And then that's all I can think of other than the Copes, which was Cope Whiskey, Cope Straight. They got the Copenhagen Straight. I forgot about that one. But. And then the Cope Smooth Hickory.
Yeah, so it looks like they have, introduced in 1822 was the original snuff, fine cut. And then the long cut was actually introduced in 1997.
Oh, damn, I was way off.
180 years.
Yeah.
later, which is pretty freaking crazy. I did not know that.
That tells you how much
they didn't even introduce. They didn't even introduce pouches until 2001.
Yeah,
this is all coming from Wikipedia, so take it with a grain of salt. But and then they started the whiskey. Or okay. Copenhagen mid-cut black. So that's what the black
is. That's the original.
It's mid-cut. It's in between extra long and regular long cut.
Yeah. That's what it was
mid-cut. And then that was released in April 2011.
Yep.
And it was replaced by long cut black. So it went from mid-cut black to
long-cut black. Which I did not care for the... It just had too much of a strong taste to it. I liked the mid-cut. The mid-cut was good. The long cut, I didn't much care for. I'd buy it every season only because it's a seasonal dip. So,
and the Copenhagen, Cope long cut whiskey blend was released in 2007, and now it's discontinued.
Yeah, okay.
So they don't even make it anymore, which is kind of sad.
It is.
Same thing goes for the Hickory.
Yeah.
It was released the exact same day.
Yep.
And it's discontinued as well.
I think all the Copes were released on the
same thing with Cope long cut straight discontinued. So they don't even make straight anymore. Which is pretty sad because
they don't make the Coke anymore.
I guess so because that's what it's looking at, because we go down the list here and here we have long cut wintergreen.
Yep.
Wasn't even introduced till 2009. And I actually remember this because I started working at Quick Trip, which, you know, of course sell cigarettes and mouth tobacco, smokeless tobacco all the time. And I remember I started working there in 2010, and I remember working there, like, right as we just got in Wintergreen Copenhagen.
Yeah.
Like, as soon as it came out in November 2009. I started working there in August 2010, and that's when we started selling it.
Yeah, I said, all the Wintergreens and mints and all that, those are new. Like, those are fairly new.
These are all very new. Even the extra long cut natural,
introduced
in 2010,
they
still make it, apparently.
Yeah.
So that's separate than the black.
Yeah.
Then after that, there's the long cut straight.
Mm-hmm.
So the long cut straight was released in 2010 under the Copenhagen name instead of Cope, and that's still around.
Yeah.
But it's slightly different than the regular Cope straight.
Yeah.
I think Cope was basically just cheaper, and I think it was probably foreign blend, just like that other stuff we were looking at earlier. All of these. I mean, even the Copenhagen Mint, that wasn't released until March of last year.
Yeah.
The Mint Pouches, same thing. The Weyman's Reserve just got released just now.
Yeah.
Like, just a month ago. Which is pretty incredible that we got it here in Stillwater, Oklahoma.
I know,
like,
dude.
A month.
Like, as soon as I heard that Wayman's Reserve was coming, the black was coming out, I went to the gas station literally every week.
Just waiting for it.
It was supposed to come out in October
here.
Like, all the signs at the gas station said, Copenhagen Black, Wayman's Reserve, October 2017. So I'd start going to the store just looking for it. I'm like, hey, I got this in yet? They're like, not yet. So then I went, I think it was like last month, like beginning of last month, end of October, beginning of November, I went in. Oh, y'all finally got it. Let me get some.
Well, it looks like to me that we have two brand new Copenhagens coming out within the next few months.
Really?
Smooth Mint and Smooth Wintergreen.
I need to try those.
Yeah, right now it says it was just released in October as a test product, only in the Pennsylvania market.
Okay.
So it's up northeast right now, bunch of pussies.
I got
some smooth, because they couldn't handle the regular.
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to trying that.
That'll be a good review. But
I feel like it'll lean more on the mint and the wintergreen flavor than it will the tobacco flavor.
Yeah.
Because with Copenhagen, you always have that. The only exception is wintergreen. I get, like, with mint, you can still taste that Copenhagen a little bit, that flavor I was talking about, that kind
of like
molasses flavor. You could taste that in the wintergreen, in the mint, but in the wintergreen, you can't. So I think, like, this smooth might kind of just be focusing more on the mint flavor than the dip.
Maybe. Like, Copenhagen mint's probably my favorite mint because it's not that overpowering mint. Grizzly mint is just, like, you put it in and...
Grizzly mint kind of chokes me up a little bit.
Right.
Or it makes your throat really dry.
Yeah.
It gives you heartburn, like you're saying.
No, that's... Grizzly mint, it's mainly the Copenhagen black is the only one that gives me heartburn.
Really,
but with the mint, I'm not a big, I like wintergreen, but I'm not a big mint dipper. Mainly because usually they don't know how to balance the mint to the tobacco.
Yeah, the mint's always too much. It's like too much mint, and it's to the point where it just dries out your throat.
Yeah.
It's, you know, whenever I don't know what the technical term is, but I call it like a dip choke. It's like where you can't swallow. Mm-hmm. Like it won't let you swallow. You physically can. It's like almost like you're on pain pills. You physically cannot swallow.
Like, or like you got cotton mouth.
Yeah, I think that pep, like I was saying earlier, that it focuses on peppermint more than the spearmint flavor. And wintergreen's kind of a spearmint, but it's like a darker spearmint.
Yeah.
I guess. Because, I mean, I've got a spearmint plant in my house, and that shit, I mean, it smells really good, but when you taste it, it's kind of strong like wintergreen, I guess. So, but, I'm looking forward to trying out those smooth mints. That'd be pretty, or smooth mint and wintergreen. So it's in Pennsylvania now, so that means if it does good,
it'll
up
be
until
released.
The end of the year, it'll be released probably in March.
Yeah, but if it doesn't do good, then...
But, you know, the farther away you are from the East Coast, the longer it's going to take.
Yeah, that's
even
why I'm...
They can ship everything out to the entire country in one night, but they never do it that way. They always kind of start working their way to the West Coast.
Like, everything... That's why I miss about Florida, because Florida was the first to get the Copenhagen Mint, Copenhagen Black, Copenhagen Wintergreen, which, whenever I was trying to get it here in Oklahoma, all my buddies back home in Florida, they're like, oh, man, they're calling me up. Dude, have you tried the Copenhagen Black yet? I'm like, I ain't got it yet. You got me one?
Yeah.
I'm like, I ain't got it here yet. He's like, dude, as soon as you get it, you need to try it. So, I guess that's one thing I miss about living in Florida is just I always, like, anytime a new dip comes out, it usually hits like the southeastern parts first because that's where the majority of dippers are, because it's all nothing but a bunch of redneck kicks. So, but then you come out here, there's dippers here, so I don't think there's nearly as many as there are down south.
No, in the south, it's more of a culture, it seems like. And even with these dip videos, I mean, you see a lot of people from the south doing this. There's that outlaw dipper guy, he's from somewhere in the south.
Well, he's
somewhere so far south, he got sweaty armpits all the time.
He actually lives in Colorado now.
Are you serious?
He's from Kentucky.
Okay, that makes sense.
Yeah, but he lives in Colorado now. You got Mud Jug, Darcy Compton from Mud Jug. He's the president of Mud Jug. His channel is Mud Jug One. He's actually from California.
Okay.
So he's usually the last person to try to do this.
Yeah, I bet. Yeah,
along
people
with,
just have to send him stuff all the time.
Yeah. Along with Chris Dips One, anytime he's another, he works with Mud Jug, Darcy, but he also lives in California. Corona, California, they're always getting packages in the mail, along with Outlaw. They're always getting packages from people on the East Coast or down south just to be like, hey, this just came out. I don't know if you have it yet. You need to do a review on this for us. So.
Yeah, I would say to sum it up, Southern Blend, yeah, it's just a good all-around go-to natural flavor. It's just, okay, let's breaking it down into, let's say, the moisture factor, 1 to 10. I would say this is about 6. So, if you like really wet dips, this is definitely not for you.
Yeah.
But if it's... this is one you could keep in for half the day. Maybe flip it around once. You know, nothing too crazy. And then on the flavor, personally, I would say very well balanced.
Mm.
It's about as good as it gets, honestly, for a natural. Pinchability, probably also about a 6, because, of course, it's not extra long cut. It's not that wet. Moisture level definitely corresponds with the pinchability with that. But what's really good, you can pack it in really good, really tight. You can take, you know, 3-finger dips out of that, and it's really not too much. The only bad thing I can see about that, you can burn through a can pretty quick.
Yeah, usually a can of Southern Blend lasts me a day and a half, 2 days at most. I've never had a can of Southern Blend last me more than 2 days. It is, since it is my favorite dip,
it's also because it tastes so damn good.
Yeah.
As soon as you spit it out, you want another.
Exactly.
Yeah.
That's one thing why I switched from Copenhagen. Used to be my everyday dip. Especially when I was in the Marines, all I dipped was Copenhagen. because I got out and then money started becoming an issue. I couldn't afford Copenhagen all the time, so I'm like, you know, I can't afford this. I'm gonna go ahead and switch to Grizzly because you still got that good natural flavor in their dips. It's not, you don't get all the stems as you do with the budget dips. And it has a good flavor to it. So, and it's also cheaper than Copenhagen by like 75 cents, 50 to 75 cents. It's not much cheaper, but
it's it's champagne dip on a beer budget. Mm-hmm. That's what I would say. It tastes a lot better than it costs. That's for
sure. Yeah.
And of course, that might vary by where you're at in the country and all that stuff. But Oklahoma, we get pretty lucky. We get some cheap-ass dip compared to the rest of the world.
I know, dude.
But then again, we don't. You go over to Arkansas, and like a can of Grizzly's $2.50.
Yeah, like,
it's pretty nuts. The same thing with Missouri. Missouri, their tobacco is insanely cheap. It's like a pack of, well, I mean, cigarettes are a little bit different, but a pack of Marlboro Reds here are almost $7. Mm-hmm. Or actually, I think they're just about
$7. Yeah. I think like last time I bought a pack of Marlboro Reds, I spent probably about $6.80 something on them. So pretty much $7 for a pack of Marlboro Reds.
Yeah, and if you live in New York State, or even worse, New York City.
Oh, yeah.
A can of dip will cost you $20, so obviously. Yeah.
Like,
you don't care anyways.
Like, whenever I was living in Florida, actually, dip in Florida is actually expensive.
Mm-hmm.
Mainly because they want their money out of it. So, they're going to charge more at places that dip a lot.
Well, and I think Florida also has a...
we also have...
They have, like, that extra fee. Like, Oklahoma just introduced that this year, actually. Yeah. Or it's going to go in effect next November. But basically, on every single pack of cigarettes, it's going to go up $1.
Yeah.
And I don't really know how it'll affect dip, but I do know that a lot more people will start dipping when cigarettes go up.
Yeah.
That's right. Just kind of how the market works. I mean, if I was paying $8 a day for a pack of cigarettes, I'd definitely be looking for a way out.
Yeah. Like, when I was in the Marines, I would smoke. I'd go to the smoke pit with the dipping, light up a cigarette, and I'll be dipping and smoking, and then I'd open up my bag of chips and throw a chai.
There you go.
Like, literally, all my other buddies in the Marines would be looking like, dude, you think you got enough nicotine in you?
No. Nah. You're also hitting an e-cig at the same time.
I'm like, shit, I'm not even getting a bud. I'm smoking my cigarette while my buddy says an e-cig. I'm like, yeah, let me get a hit off of that. All right, thanks, man.
Yeah. Yeah, see, now that's what you would call fiending.
Yeah, so now, mainly, I still smoke occasionally, but I mainly smoke when I drink, which is surprising. I mean, I shouldn't say I smoke when I drink, because I drink all the time. I
drink constantly.
Yeah, I smoke when I'm out drinking socially.
Yeah, I would say on average, every month, I probably smoke 15 cigarettes. I haven't bought a pack of cigarettes in over 2 years, probably. Oh, longer than that. It's been longer than that.
Yeah, I bought a pack of cigarettes 2 weeks ago, and I smoked my last one today on my way to work. Only because...
That's crazy.
I know, dude.
Yeah, sometimes you just kind of feel like smoking cigarettes, sometimes you don't.
Like, especially since I work customer service around food, I don't want to have, like, fucking dip in my teeth and everything. So, I'll be on the way to work. I want to get a little bit of a nicotine buzz, which I honestly don't get anymore, which is kind of sad. I'm hoping
to smoke a whole cigar on the way to work.
I'm hoping when I do this full can challenge, I'll get a buzz off of it.
Well, you probably will.
Oh, yeah. I'm sure I will. About the only time I can get a buzz.
A whole can is, what, 10 dips probably?
Well, to me, it's about, like, I take... Usually, for these videos, I don't take near as big of a lift as I normally do. But, like, whenever I'm not doing these videos, I'm usually taking a 3-4 finger pinch.
Yeah, like, whenever I did Red Seal, I still buy Red Seal. I only buy one can about every 2 weeks.
Really. Oh, shit.
But when I was working a lot in Tulsa, doing a bunch of landscaping, a bunch of outdoor work, I'd go through one can of Red Seal every 2 days. But I would leave in a dip for 3 or 4 hours.
Yeah.
So it wasn't really like just in and out, but One thing I will say is that with Red Seal, when you're dipping it for that long, you don't even taste flavor anymore.
No.
I feel like if you were dipping the Southern Cut, you'd be tasting it all day. Because that's another thing, too, with Wintergreen or Mint. Like, after a while, you don't even taste the Wintergreen.
No, no. Like, I mean, we're already 40 minutes into this video, and we've had the dip in probably about, what, 38 minutes or so?
Yeah, at
least. And I still have plenty of flavor left in it. So it's not a lack of flavor.
Yeah.
Like, with the flavor on Southern Blend, I personally give it a 10. Not only because it's my favorite dip, but because the flavor is so well balanced. I mean, you got so many flavors intertwined in there so perfectly. You got the smokiness, you got the molasses, you got the natural flavors, and they are blended together perfectly.
Well, and it kind of changes flavors as time goes on, because like I'm noticing now, just that you said it, it's drying out. But also, I mean, 40 minutes into having a dip, that's quite a long time.
Yeah.
Like, for me anyways, usually about this time I'm about to go get some food or something and fucking spit it out. But with this, it's actually kind of starting to taste more like chew almost. It's sweet.
Yeah.
That's kind of getting that raisin flavor.
That's the molasses from it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know if you've ever had molasses, but molasses, it's like, it's sort of like
it's
a
syrup. Sweet, but not
but
insane. It's not
it's
like
a very thick sort of like a syrup, but it has that very sweet taste to it, like raisins.
It's kind of like just dipping your finger in sugar and licking it.
Yeah.
It's not like sweet like candy, but it's got like that kind of,
yeah,
like sweet tea. Yeah. Honestly, I could compare the flavor of this to sweet tea.
That's actually one that, that's like, especially when you first put it in, you get that smokiness taste to it. But after a while, you start, it sort of tastes like you're dipping on sweet tea. Like,
yeah, it kind of is. Yeah. You can kind of, like, it's weird, but you can taste, like, the leafiness, too.
Mm-hmm.
It tastes like a plant, which is good, because after the end of the day, you are dipping a plant. It's not all fiberglass, like people fucking say.
Yeah, no.
Nothing is actually fiberglass.
That is.
Maybe kayak. But not this shit.
Yeah.
Like,
no, literally, those of y'all that believe that there's fiberglass in dip, if there, I'll tell y'all, this is scientifically proven. If there was fiberglass in dip, soon as you put it in, your gums would start bleeding uncontrollably. And because fiberglass has a non-clotting agent within it, your gums would not be able to clog themselves.
Fiberglass is actually porous itself.
Yeah.
So like if a fiber goes in your gum, it's basically like sticking a miniature straw.
Yeah.
So like whatever starts bleeding, it's going to keep coming out.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never, ever, ever had my gums bleed from dipping. I've had my gums recede
from
dipping way too much. But then once I do that, you back off a little bit. You start putting in smaller pinches.
Yeah, you put in smaller pinches. Or what I usually do whenever I call it alligator mouth. Like whenever you run your tongue over and you
feel, it's kind of leathery.
Yeah, you feel like, I don't know where y'all are from or what y'all did. But if you've ever felt an alligator, you got that scaly, rough skin, which after you dip,
Florida gator mouth.
Yeah, man.
That's what it's called.
So, after you dip a lot in one day, you start getting that rough feeling in your mouth, like you're, if I call it alligator mouth, because it feels like alligator scales in your mouth. So, usually when I do that, I'm not a big pouch dipper, but whenever I start doing that, I'll throw in a couple pouches just until my gums start feeling a little better.
Yeah.
And then the scales start going away, and then I'll throw in.
I think all that is from the tissue in your mouth is absorbing all that stuff. It's the same thing if you kept a paper towel in your mouth for fucking six hours, it would do the same thing. It's the same concept as your fingers getting wrinkled in the shower.
Mm-hmm.
It's just, you know, too much water, your body clenches up to, you know, stop that from happening. That's all that's happening in your mouth. But yeah, like, that's like the big scare tactic of the day.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when I was in high school, you know. They always have those anti-tobacco crusaders that come in there. And, you know what I'm talking about.
Dipping gas fiberglass. The state-funded. You're going to get cancer from it. And another
hairy
thing.
You get hairy tongue.
Yeah. Another thing about dipping. This has also been scientifically proven. If you do not believe me, you can go check out Mudjug One's channel and look up dipping does not cause cancer, I think is what the video is called. But he actually had, what's the cancer doctors called? Oncologists?
Oncologist.
He was talking with an oncologist, and the oncologist said that he's been an oncologist for like 20 years. He's renewed all his certifications and everything, so he's up to date. But he has said that out of all the cancer patients he has had, none of who have mouth cancer, like, and he was saying he has treated like hundreds and hundreds of people with mouth cancer. The only ones that he found, like, the only ones he found got it from dipping were like two or three, and it only happened within the first 7 years of dipping.
Yeah, another thing is that half the time, like, mouth cancer is actually caused by drinking and smoking combined.
Yeah.
Because whenever you're drinking alcohol, it breaks down all that healthy bacteria that's in your mouth.
Mm-hmm.
There's healthy bacteria in your mouth. There's healthy bacteria in your stomach. There's actually more living organisms in your body than there are cells in your body. So, obviously, when you throw something else in there that's foreign, yeah, it might throw things in whack. But another big thing is esophageal cancer, which is a cancer of the esophagus, throat cancer. A lot of people say, yeah, it's caused by dipping. I actually have a family friend that got throat cancer from nothing.
Yeah.
Genetic.
It's but cancer is actually more genetic than anything.
Yeah, it really is.
If you have, like, if somebody in your family has ever had cancer and they haven't, yeah, maybe they've smoked. But smoking, it can cause cancer, but necessarily it does not have to cause cancer.
No, because, like, when you look at the cancer-causing agents in any sort of smoke or tobacco-related stuff is carcinogens. And basically all that is the burning of carbon.
Yeah.
So it's like, let's say...
But, I mean, there's more carbon in the atmosphere that we breathe every single day than there is...
Especially if you live in an urban environment. Like,
yeah.
If you live, like, what was it?
New York.
In Delhi, in India.
Yeah.
New Delhi.
New Delhi.
Which is actually... I forgot what it was. History class. Let's see here. After India... For a while it was settled by the British imperialists, much like the U.S. But after they left, a lot of their environmental guidelines left also, and they actually have air in New Delhi, which is the capital of India, if I'm not wrong.
It is.
It's either that or Calcutta, which whatever. There's billions of people there, so it really doesn't matter. It's probably all the same. Small-minded. But a good caveat to that is their air quality is the equivalent to smoking two packs of cigarettes a day. So, I mean, obviously that's going to cause some problems somewhere along the lines.
Yeah.
But yeah, personally, I'm not a scientist. I'm not a doctor. I flip hamburgers for a living right now. I'm a college student. I don't know shit according to my grades. So... I would say, mouth tobacco, if you want tobacco, that's the most pure way to get it in your system. Filling your lungs up with smoke that's got a filter on it and paper, and you got filler material, which isn't tobacco. It's actually tobacco scraps mixed with paper that's soaked in the tobacco juice.
Mm-hmm.
That's what you get from cigarettes, and that's why it's so bad. That's why people are talking about tar and shit. If you get a naturally rolled cigarette like Bugles, you know, the Bugler with the papers and everything, those are way better for you than anything else.
Tops is another one.
And of course, if you're smoking anything, there's going to be tar. If you smoke weed, there's going to be resin building up in your lungs. But the only bad thing is that with tobacco, there's certain carcinogens in it. And that's what it is. It's like, it's, let's say, have you ever burned charcoal before that's been wet before?
Yeah.
It doesn't turn into pure ash. It turns into like little black chunks.
Mm-hmm.
Same concept, I think.
Yeah. But also, like, honestly, like the doctor on the Mojoke One's video said, like, if you do dip, you, like, out of the millions of people that do dip, only about maybe 2 or 3% of them will develop mouth cancer from it. And that only happens within the first 7 years of dipping.
Yeah, and it could also be attributed to poor hygiene, too.
Poor hygiene, genetics.
Like not brushing your teeth after. If you dip a can a day and you don't brush your teeth, Like, what the fuck else do you expect to happen?
Yeah, exactly. And it also comes down
or
to the genetics.
If you swallow a lot of dip,
yeah.
What the fuck else do you expect to happen? It's just, you know, it's just,
it's crazy.
Actually, I think in emergency rooms they use, like, nicotine sometimes mixed with that charcoal
powder
to make people throw up if they can't pump their stomach for some reason.
Mm-hmm.
It's
pretty That's actually happened to me a couple times. Alcohol poisoning.
I've never had that. I did have alcohol poisoning once.
Oh, shit.
And it led to a terrible misadventure where we ended up stealing a headstone from a cemetery.
Oh, nice.
Some pretty rough stuff.
Shit, I died from alcohol poisoning a couple
Hopefully
years
the,
ago.
The statute of limitations is longer than 8 years because...
Yes.
Did some pretty fucked up stuff, but yeah, that's like, everything in moderation is all right.
Yeah.
I mean, even like hard drugs in moderation are, well, I mean, of course they're not all right, because if you're on heroin and you fall over and hit your head on something, yeah, and I'm not endorsing doing heroin, but everything for the most part is all right in moderation,
yeah.
Especially dip. And if you're dipping 2 cans a day, obviously you got a fucking problem. That's a lot. I don't even know how you find the time to...
I used to do it 3 cans a day.
How the hell do you even do that?
Oh, I was a fucking Marine. Now
well,
I got shit else
sense.
To do.
Yeah, my buddy Carlos that came back from the Marines, he just got out. And I remember his first time back on leave. Like, he was at Pendleton for basic training. And then as soon as he got out of basic training, he just got stationed in Pendleton.
Mm.
And California is like the worst place. If you want any sort of personal freedoms,
hell,
it will do anything. And he wanted to buy a bunch of cigarettes and shit while he's there and dip. And he couldn't because it's so expensive. As soon as he got back to Oklahoma, he bought three cartons of cigarettes and like 10 rolls of dip. And he just went nuts. And it was all gone within 2 weeks.
Dude.
Just like he was handing out cigarettes to people, giving dips to people.
Oh, no,
still,
shit, dude.
2 weeks, I mean, you don't have that many friends. That's crazy.
Whenever I was in the Marines and we'll do a field exercise, I'd go to the fucking PX on base. I'd buy like 4 cans of fucking Grizzly.
Yeah,
five
and back
cans
then it was like 12. It was, everything was jacked up.
Yeah,
it's like if you go to the campus right now and buy a thing of Oreos, it's $8. It's the same thing.
Yeah, but I'd buy like 4 rolls of Grizzly, 5 rolls of fucking Copenhagen, and a few cans of Skull Kayak, Kodiak, all that shit. And then I'd have people coming up to me, "Hey, Southern, I forgot to get dip before this field exercise. You got any?" I'm like, "Yeah, you got $10 on you? I'll sell them a fucking can for $10 because, shit, they needed it." I never went with two things, especially if you're in the military, and say, you know, approve of this. Two things you never want to go to a field without, especially if you dip or smoke or something. Tobacco, whether if you smoke cigarettes, if you dip, and toilet paper. Those are two things you never want to forget when you're in the military going for a field exercise. Those two things alone can make you... fucking horrible field exercise turn into, I really don't want to do this, but the dip of having my lip and knowing that I'll be able to wipe my ass when I need to take a shit helps. But, yeah. Shit. But, yeah, I've had this in for almost an hour now, and it's still plenty of flavor.
I mean, it's a great dip.
Dude,
and we've just been sitting here. We haven't been moving around. So if you're moving around, you're producing more saliva, all that shit. This is a great dip. It actually makes me want to buy some because I've been hooked on Red Seal Wintergreen for... I haven't bought anything other than Red Seal Wintergreen or Copenhagen Wintergreen in probably the past year.
There.
So
see, with me, I'm a big Wintergreen fan. I love the flavors of it. But I like trying different things and just giving my mouth something else other than just wintergreen all the time.
Mm-hmm.
So I always pretty much every couple weeks or so I'll go buy something else. I'll be like, shit, I want a straight. Let me get a straight. Shit, I want a fucking natural. Let me get a natural. I want a mint. Let me get a mint. I always want to try and mix it up, not only because I collect cans, but also I like different flavors. The other day, I actually had, like, a pinch of Stoker's Wintergreen and a pinch of Stoker's Mint, though. So, and a pinch of Stoker's straight less. I just went ahead and did a pinch of each of them. Mm-hmm. I had three pinches in my lip. Not very good.
Those are some weird flavors to mix.
They were horrible, man. I had that in for maybe like 2 minutes, and it was just disgusting.
Oh, yeah. Another good thing I would say about this Southern Blend, or really any Copenhagen for that matter, is I don't know about most people because I don't know shit, but it's hard for me to drink anything when I got a dip in. Maybe it's just like a small mouth or fucking who knows. But, yeah, you know, it's like really, really easy to drink beer with this stuff. It's drink. I could drink something sugary. Because, you know, like when you drink something sugary, you're like, your spit gets all thick.
Mm-hmm.
With this, I mean, you'll have that, but it's like, shit, you could drink beer all day on this thing. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's...
No, one thing...
I usually got to spit. Like, if I'm at a bar and I go in with a dip in, I can drink a beer or two. But then, like, once I start drinking, like, liquor drinks, I got to spit that dip out because it's just, like, it's too much. This, I feel like it's mild enough to where you can... And it's dry enough, too.
Yeah.
It's not like... it's not... Every time you swallow a drink, you're not going to be swallowing dip spit. And that's a good thing, also.
Another thing about it is, with a lot of budget dips, I have trouble drinking anything with them. I still can, but it's harder than if I'm have a dip of Grizzly or a dip of Copenhagen because they pack and they pinch so much better, so you actually get a tighter pinch into
exactly.
It.
Like
so
with Stoker's, like you have a huge, huge pinch of Stoker's, which is what you gotta do. If you got, especially if you got the tub, you gotta take the biggest fucking dips.
Dude, I fucking
like we're talking all five fingers, like a whole four finger pinch right there.
Fucking full can pinch.
A whole a grasp. Just a bang.
Just grab it and just
a claw machine. That that stuff, it's really hard to drink with.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, this it's good, doesn't dry out your mouth too much, but it also doesn't dry out your mouth at all, really.
Yeah.
But it's not like it has it's not like you just got a giant pile of blood sitting here.
Yeah,
it's good stuff.
Like, yeah, I haven't rotated this once, and it's still. I mean, I'm starting.
It's been an entire hour. And
yeah,
it's still.
I'm starting to.
And while talking and stuff.
Yeah, I'm starting to lose a little bit of the flavor. So I'm probably about to turn it over.
And I've got a decent amount of spit going. I mean, this thing's about halfway full.
I'm about to have to pour this out. Those of y'all that don't know how to empty out a fucking stealth mud jug, it's really easy. I'll show y'all right now.
Let me go get a cup. I'll be right back. We'll be right back after these messages. Oh, yeah. Also, if you're under 18, don't dip because laws.
Yeah, I started dipping when I was like, shit, was I 10 or 11 when I started dipping? All right.
I didn't start until I was 14.
Dude, this is how you empty out the stealth. It's a twist off.
Boom.
So you do this.
Just like those weird ass aluminum can bottle things.
And then you just pour it out. Just like that. And then
you drink it.
You might have some, especially if it's full, you're going to have some build up in the funnel. So just do it.
You're going to want to blow out that.
Do a quick blow. And then.
Quick blow. Will Southern Special.
It's in.
Blowing.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Man, right there.
Good as new.
Empty mud jug.
On your way to fill it up again.
Yep. But
there it is.
Yeah. But yeah, I'd recommend Copenhagen Southern Blend. I recommend any Copenhagen at all, only because it's my favorite brand of dip. It's just so expensive. It's not expensive here as it is in Florida, but it's still, you're still paying about $5-6 a can here.
Yeah, it's, I don't know why the price is like that.
It's the most well, other than Grizzly, it's the most well-known dip. Like.
Yeah, I guess so. Well, the quality also.
The quality, you can.
I would put, like,
you
any,
cannot
any
put,
day, personally, I would put Copenhagen over.
Yeah, Copenhagen is the best brand.
It's the pinnacle. It's the,
yeah.
It's the best of the best.
And, it is the brand that started it all.
It's the brand that started it all. and it's also the most consistent. Like I've
been
saying, I have, it's the most consistent dip
I have ever get. Other than the Coke brands, which I think is why they were discontinued, other than the Coke brands, I have not had a Copenhagen that I have not liked. Every single Copenhagen I have tried, I like. Even the mint, and I am not a huge mint guy, but I like Copenhagen mint.
Yeah, Copenhagen mint is like, it's meant for people that don't like mint. And like, Copenhagen is a great way, if you're trying to try out flavored dip, if you're like a, you know, 50-year-old guy, and you've been dipping the same boring shit your whole life, and you're just like, man, maybe my wife would like me more if I fucking dipped a little bit of wintergreen every now and then, I would say, go ahead and try some Copenhagen.
The way I describe Copenhagen mint, it is the dip that you can kiss your girlfriend with.
Yeah.
It is.
Yeah, it is.
I am proof of that.
You don't smell like dog shit?
I know. Like, you don't have that tobacco smell in your mouth. You actually have. It is the dip breath mint.
So you're a front dipper.
Yeah.
I'm back. I'm more of a molar guy. I keep the chipmunk cheeks.
Hey, I mean, I switch it around depending on. I usually pack it in the front at first.
It moves its way back.
I move it with my tongue.
Yeah, I always keep mine on the left side.
But mostly, I either pack it near the, like, not in the directly in the middle, but sort of in between the back and the middle of my right or my left or my right.
Mm-hmm. Well, and here we are an hour later, and I just flipped it over, and it's just, like, brand new again.
I haven't even flipped mine over yet.
If I was dipping Red Seal right now, I would have spit it out 30 minutes ago and threw it in a new one.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah.
That's one thing about budget dips. The flavors do not last in them.
It's like cheap gum.
It is. Like,
it's the same thing. It's like one of those little 35-cent packs of gum versus a thing of five or Stride or whatever the fuck. It's way better.
It is.
The flavor lasts. I think that's also in part to the molasses and the sugar that's in there.
Yeah.
It makes it, because like a sugar, the taste will never really dissipate as fast as, like, say something artificial would.
Mm-hmm.
Artificial sweeteners definitely lose their taste faster. And I'm not sure if they use natural. I mean, it's got to be natural flavors. Besides the wintergreen and the mint, obviously. I mean, and, like, if you get Skull, like, if you're one of those fruitcakes that does Skull all the time. Like, citrus blend is about the only one of those that I can handle. All the others, cherry. If you dip Skull cherry, just go ahead and just jump off of whatever the tallest place around you is, because that shit is disgusting.
The only time I ever even buy Skull cherry is whenever I mix it with Grizzly Straight to make a Dr. Pepper.
Oh, yeah, that's what you're saying, yeah.
Yeah, dude. Mm-hmm. If y'all have not tried that, y'all need to go. This is the only time it is acceptable to buy Skull cherry, is if you buy a can of Skull cherry with a can of Grizzly Straight. You put one third part of the Skull cherry, the two third part of Grizzly Straight. You mix them together really well. When you put it in your lip, it tastes like fucking Dr. Pepper.
Well, if you mix that with some vanilla Tough Guy, that'd be pretty incredible, actually. Cherry and vanilla.
Dude.
But a full thing of cherry, a full dip of cherry.
Mm-mm.
Woo! You must love cough syrup. Like, seriously, that's all it tastes like. It's not good. It's terrible.
No, all right. You know what Pepto-Bismol tastes like?
Yeah, gross.
Yeah.
Powdery, but wet somehow.
Fuck it, I think it is Skull Wintergreen. It's either Skull Wintergreen or Skull Berry. Tastes like fucking Pepto-Bismol. It is a Skull. There is a certain Skull.
Skullberry.
I fucking hate Skullberry. Every time I put a pinch of Skullberry in, I get sick.
Yeah, I think Skullberry was actually probably the first dip I ever tried. It was in Pouches with my friend's older brother. He's dead now, but one of my good friends growing up, his older brother had some. And we found it, like, because his older brother gave him, like, a dresser.
Mm-hmm.
And we were, like, putting shit in his dresser. and there was like an empty can of dip in there. It had two of those pouches left. And they were dry as fuck.
Yeah.
Just absolutely dry. So we put like a little orange peel in there to kind of, you know, kind of like what you do with weed or whatever.
Yeah.
Kind of, you know, get some moisture back in there. And man, it tasted fucking terrible. But like, that was my first dip experience ever, so.
Oh, no. I got a challenge. If I can get to 100 subscribers, I will do a full can of Skullberry.
I'd like to see that.
Yeah.
First, I'd like you to try to find a full can of Skullberry around here, because nobody
found it. I know.
So that would be part one. Part two is actually doing it.
I'll call one of my buddies back in Florida. I know one of my buddies, all he dibs is Skullberry. I told him he needs to take.
Does he have a boyfriend?
Actually, he is a gay Marine, so.
Well, there you go.
I told him, like, whenever I first seen him dip Skullberry, I'm like, dude, you need to have your man card removed. He's like, oh, I'm gay. I don't have one of those. I'm like,
well, there you go.
All right. Problem solved.
Yep. It all boils down to what you did.
Yep.
You can tell a lot about a person about what they did.
What does what I did tell you about me?
Man of variety.
I am.
Many different colors. Some would say a rainbow.
Fuck you.
You're an entire rainbow of colors. But yeah, that's a Copenhagen Southern Blend.
Yeah.
Being from the South, get a little taste.
I know. So the way I describe Southern Blend, especially if you're up north, put a dip in a Southern Blend in, you see what the South's all about.
There you go, because like I'm not from the South. I don't even know where the fuck I'm from. Oklahoma is like the this is Indian Territory. I'm from Indian Territory.
Central.
Middle of nowhere. Nobody gives a shit about North Texas besides Dallas.
Oklahoma.
Oklahoma.
Kansas.
Is basically.
What the fuck are you watching over there?
I don't know. I just pulled it up and it's Teen Vogue. I don't know.
This dude reads Teen Vogue.
Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what I'm looking at here. I went from Copenhagen to Teen Vogue really quick. My finger was doing some things on accident here. But yeah, Copenhagen Southern Blend. Try it out. If you don't, good luck trying to find some flavor out there in the sad world.
I think that's about it for this video. Hope y'all enjoy. Like. Comment what I should do next. Subscribe to my channel if you already have it.
Interact. Yeah. Send us free shit.
I know. Like I said, 100 subscribers, I'll do a full can of Skullberry. I
won't even charge you for it.
Yep. Y'all get to see me puke. I'll make sure I have a trash can there here so y'all can see me puke.
Steve-O style.
Yes.
You gotta do it right in front of everybody.
Oh, yeah. All right. I'm gonna promise y'all this. If y'all get me up to 100 subscribers, y'all will see me throw up.
Yep, that's a good deal.
So.
Sounds good to me.
Hey, y'all already subscribe. Watch the video. Tell your friends to subscribe. Share this video.
Is that probably one of your longest ones yet?
Oh, this is my longest one, dude. They usually run around 15 minutes.
Oh, well, they're getting a... you don't have to do another one for a month now.
I know, dude.
Yeah,
they're
cool.
But I'll probably like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what video, what I should do next. So I'll see y'all later. Y'all have a good night. God bless.